Welcome to the training Integrate with SPAPI. Step 2C, set up a self-authorization procedure. This video is designed for developers who want to integrate an application with Selling Partner API. It covers one version of the second step in the integration process, providing step-by-step instructions for a private seller or vendor application. If you want to integrate a public seller application initiated from a Selling Partner App Store detail page, please proceed to Step 2A. Set up a test Selling Partner App Store authorization workflow for relevant instructions. Or if you want to integrate a public seller or vendor application initiated from your own website, please proceed to Step 2B, set up a test website authorization workflow. We also cover earlier and later steps for SPAPI integration in other videos. And you can find written instructions for each step by searching for the Selling Partner API documentation website. As a reminder, before you begin setting up a self-authorization procedure, you'll need to register your application. For information about that process, refer to the first video in our Integrate with SPAPI series. It's also worth noting that a self-authorized application can remain in draft status even after you've finished testing it, unlike the Test Selling Partner App Store or website authorization workflows we cover in our Step 2A and Step 2B videos. That's because there's no reason to publish a private application. To self-authorize a private application for a seller or vendor, start by signing in to Developer Central through either your Seller Central or Vendor Central account. After signing in to Seller Central, select Partner Network from the main menu, then click Develop Apps to access Developer Central. After signing in to Vendor Central, select Integration from the main menu, then click API Integration. Next, from your Developer Central homepage, click the arrow beside the Edit App button for the application you want to authorize, and click Authorize. This will take you to the Authorize Application page, where you can click the Authorize App button for the Selling Partner account you want your application to access. You can also click multiple Authorize App buttons to access multiple accounts. If the Selling Partner's account is merged with accounts in other regions, each account will have its own Authorize App button. The Stores column indicates the stores in which an account is active. A login with Amazon or LWA refresh token will appear. If you click an Authorize App button multiple times, a new refresh token will be generated with each click. If you click multiple Authorize App buttons, tokens appear for each Selling Partner account you authorized your application to access. Note that new refresh tokens won't invalidate previous tokens. Finally, save a refresh token for each Selling Partner account you authorized your application to access. Your private application will now be self-authorized to access one or more accounts. After your self-authorization procedure is in place, you'll have completed Step 2C of the SPAPI integration process and will be ready to move to Step 3, connecting to SPAPI. We encourage you to watch the next video about that process. Choose the relevant version of our Step 3 video based on how you want to exchange the LWA refresh token you received at the end of Step 2C for an LWA access token. If you want to exchange a refresh token for an access token using a generated Java SDK, proceed to Step 3A, connect to SPAPI using a generated Java SDK. If you want to manually exchange a refresh token for an access token, proceed to Step 3B, connect to SPAPI manually. Thanks for watching.